Well, this has been my bed for the last 2 days. It's just so hot downstairs that you can't get any breeze, so I've had to come upstairs for a bit of relief until the air conditioning is repaired. I'm not so much of an early riser myself. Back home, I'd be working till kind of like 12 or 1 o'clock in the morning, and then struggle to get up, kind of around about 7, 8. But here I love being up early. You know, it's great to be up at like 6 o'clock in the morning, watch the sun come up. It's dead peaceful, calm, no one's here. It's nice, really nice. Very peaceful.
Biscuit and I have decided that we've got to stop the drinking and we're gonna get fit. Happy with Biscuit. We've got a month until we head home, we think, we hope. And so Colin and I have decided we're gonna cut the booze and do a little bit of a detox, get ourselves exercising every day again, because we've fallen off the wagon quite majorly for the year. And it's been a year. And we used to be really good, going to boot camp, going to fitness classes, doing Pilates, and since we got on the boat, we've been terrible. And the drinking is at exponential levels. So, we are going to do small exercises every day to tick us over. 30 press-ups, 30 kettlebells, 30 sit-ups, 30 squats and planks. And then we're going to do some couple stretches that we did with our German friends, some yoga couple stretches. And then we're going to do a long run, walk or swim every day.
It's a 30-day challenge, right?
It's a 30-day challenge. And we're going to cut out the coffee and the alcohol predominantly and just get ourselves back on the fresh greens. Our diet's pretty good anyway, but then you spend time with friends in places and you end up going to restaurants and ordering stuff, and you know, when we eat on the boat, we eat really well.
How's that tail? You wagging the tail?
Yes, good girl.
Hey? Huh? Hard life, yeah. Hard life.
For the start of our detox day.
Very healthy. Omelette with feta, spinach, ginger, spring onions. Got some Tabasco and some cayenne in there. It's really kind of Japanese fusion. Yummy.
Mint tea.
Herbal tea, please. To help the morning ablutions.
So what are you doing?
Okay, so this is a game. It's a Tabasco and...
Tabasco?
You said curry powder! You said apple cider vinegar! You did nothing. You have said nothing with Tabasco.
Let me finish. It's apple cider vinegar with a little dash of Tabasco.
Okay.
To now, make it taste nicer.
The rule is, basically what happens is they have to flip these cups, and if the cup lands on its face or its bum, that person can move this cup one side up. If you flip it, it lands on its bum or its top, you move it back this way. So it's gonna keep going like this. Whoever gets the glass on this side has to drink it. If it goes onto this side, you have to drink it. Capiche?
Well,
when is Emily playing?
I don't play.
Are you playing against Daddy Ems?
No.
She said no to the game.
She said no to the game.
That's her child.
Thank you.
landed.
Too late.
Oh no!
Okay, all in one. Off you go.
Can you taste this?
All in one, no messing about. Go.
No.
Come on, hurry up.
It's only vinegar and Tabasco. What's wrong with you?
Only vinegar and Tabasco. Nice.
Go.
I thought I would do, Colin and I are on a bit of a health kick. So I'm doing a little breakfast alternative with bacon, and I'm using coconut flour and natural yogurts. So there's no wheat or anything in it, but it should be a little breakfast muffin.
Is this a snack?
Well, it's meant to be like a breakfast substitute, I suppose.
So what's in it?
Yeah, spring onions, spinach, apple, egg, coconut flour, and cheese, and bacon. It's getting less and less healthy.
And you've got some sous chefs with you today, have you?
I have Olivia, who's gonna be...
I'm Olivia, I will be Rebecca's sous chef for today.
I'm head chef, just letting you know.
Well, she does nothing, just stares there.
No, I'm doing the most important job.
Okay, so what are you doing, Olivia?
I am putting the bacon in, so all the goodness goes in there. That's like
okay,
the...
Keep going.
Chopping up apple. We need to do an Emily one of these, Olivia. So those two will be for Emily without bacon on. So what we have is we have the makings of a slightly different breakfast muffin. It's a little bit after breakfast. We've all had a bit of a lazy day. And as imaged by Emily, as she's sitting over the other side waiting to be fed. And we're all just going to have a bit of fun making something a bit different. See if it works out. See if we like it. My cutting skills, they're not as good as Colin's.
What are you doing, Jess?
I'm grating cheese.
Is that going to go in the mixture?
Yep.
And the Queen of Sheba, what are you doing?
I'm chilling. They have already too many hands to...
What happens if too many cooks get involved?
Spoil the broth.
It's coconut flour. Natural yogurt. You could use... Yeah. You could use coconut yogurt for this, again, if you want to stay away from goat's products. I love goat. We'll see. With a bit of parmesan. Good?
Yeah.
Great. You look amazing.
So, in St. Thomas we have discovered Badass, which is a coffee place, and it does really, really good cookies. All three of us love them. And we were eating them today, and our dad says, can I have some? And we're like, yeah, sure. And he goes, I can make these better. He goes, well, we don't think so. These are really good. And so now we've challenged him to make the best cookies in the world. And, you know, I'll be the judge testing every single one. me included. And, yeah, so now he's got to prove himself.
So, I'm Chef Jessica McGowan, and I'm going to be making the best cookies in the world with my dad. Let's hope they work out well.
Whose recipe is it?
Daddy's.
Let's see it works.
So, we don't have a weighing scale, so hopefully Daddy will memorise the measurements and they'll all work out well. For the cookies, we need 3 cups of plain flour, 1 cup of caster sugar, and then 1¼ cups of brown sugar. 225 grams of butter. Now we are adding eggs slowly. And a sprinkle of cinnamon. Now we have finished the dry mix, which is the plain flour, salt, and bicarbonate soda. Now we are on the wet mix. Now the fun part, adding chocolate chips. To know that your mix is ready, you place your hand on the dough, and if it doesn't stick to your hand, then you know it is ready.
So while we're making cookies, what are you doing?
Well, Biscuit's very excited about cookies, but we're having a cuddle.
That's why she's called Biscuit.
And what are you doing?
That's why she's called
Vicky.
Biscuit.
I've just got that. Excited. We're making cookies. What about you, Lou? Are you building up your merchandise?
Yeah.
Thanks for the chat.
To roll the mixture into a sausage in the clean film, and then we're going to put it in the freezer, and then we're going to slice it into cookie shapes. Now it is ready to go in the freezer.
Not with the flashing light.
Can't wait to try them.
Is that cookie job done?
Yes.
Pastry chef.
I think Pepsi the sous chef. She's amazing.
Now we put them in the oven at 200 degrees, 20 minutes.
Does it fit?
Taste it.
Taste it.
We hope.
It's on the oven.
Here.